what our fans are going to be like when you have the hated Patriots. I mean, the this kind of rival coming into our stadium. I don't know if a whole lot's changed. The fact that they're, you know, they're kind of the hunted in my eyes, because they're, you know, they're the world champions. And so they were obviously won our division every single year that I've been here. So obviously they're the ones that you want to knock off.
I think Rex is liking the blue. He's always played Tom Brady and the Patriots tough as Jets head coach, obviously now staying in the division with the Bills. He inherits another solid defense and gets to face the Patriots twice a year again. Rex is fired up and ready for Bill Belichick and Brady to come to town on Sunday. But take a look at the numbers here. Brady's stats are lower in every statistical category when facing Rex Ryan. Interesting. Skip, why has Rex been able to be so successful against Brady?
Stephen A. Smith, I'm going to use a word here I don't often use on this show, and that's genius. I believe Rex Ryan is a defensive genius. I believe he's a better all-around defensive football coach than Bill Belichick. Yet Belichick's aura, his legend, his brand seems a lot bigger than Rex's as a defensive coordinating type of a strategic coach. And I don't buy it. I love Bill Belichick, as you well know. And I can make a case, certainly, that Bill Belichick is a better all-around head football coach than Rex Ryan, but not defensively. And yet, as we just saw from that soundbite, that little bit of clip that we just saw from Rex, which is only the tip of that iceberg, as you well know, Rex's showmanship continues to overshadow his strategic brilliance, because he doesn't look or act like a genius, but he is. Now, he gets a lot of help, and I think it's time for us to start to give some credit to his now defensive coordinator, Dennis Thurman, who's now calling a lot of the defenses. But with some help from Dennis, it's mostly Rex through the week compiling a game plan that always frustrates and flusters Tom Brady. Not that they're going to shut him down. They're just going to occasionally confuse him enough that Brady's a little off balance against Rex. He's not sure what's coming next, because nobody is sure what's coming next from Rex. Blitz-wise, look-wise, pass defense-wise, coverage-wise, it's always something a little bit different. And Rex is flat out arrogant about it. He's outspokenly arrogant about it. So that trickles down to his locker room. And his defenders start to get arrogant about it and think, hey, we're as good as Tom Brady is. We can do what we do as well as Tom Brady does what he does. So they're one team, and maybe the only team, now in Buffalo, obviously, used to be with the Jets, but it's the only team that's not afraid of Tom Brady, that doesn't play on its heels against Tom Brady. They attack Tom Brady because they are supremely confident they can control Tom Brady, and they often have. Again, not that he's bad against them, he's just not Tom Brady against Rex Ryan. Advantage Rex. So he constantly drops in his little lines that we play the Patriots. You know, it's just Rex, and it's funny. Makes Molly laugh, me laugh. But it's showmanship, but it's showing the players again. Rex ain't afraid of no Patriot, mm-hmm. No Belichick. He's got, you know, he's on Tom Brady. You know, I don't use that word very often, but I can go so far, because I have so much respect for Brady, to say this is the one guy who has mentally owned Tom Brady. That's flat out genius that Rex is not going to get full credit for, because too often he's a little bit of a clown act. I'm sorry, but he is. It's funny and it's entertaining, but it takes away from the truth of this matter that this guy is really gifted at coaching defensive football.
That's a really good point.
Thank
it's
you.
Almost he doesn't need to do it.
No, he doesn't. I mean, I don't, even though we all love that he does it.
Yeah, we enjoy it. But
anyway, fire away, Stephen A.
Well, he may be a showman and what have you, but let's give credit where credit is due. Rex Ryan means what he says, particularly when it comes to the Patriots. He may be a showman. When he came into New York, even though a lot of people ultimately felt he departed as a clown, I never felt that way about Rex Ryan because I recognized what the Jets were before he got there. And the fact that he took them to two straight AFC championship games, and if you remember that second year he went there, in the regular season, the Patriots had beaten the Jets 45-3. And then a month later, they met in the playoffs, and they beat Tom Brady and the New England Patriots. I think it was like 28-21, and Mark Sanchez had thrown about three touchdowns or so, if I remember correctly. The point is, Rex Ryan has had a few occasions. He's lost to the Patriots more than he's won against them, but he's beaten them a few times, number one. Number two, I think that primarily, it's because he's had Tom Brady tap dancing in the pocket, like the late great Gregory Hines, God rest his soul. Just like I told
you
in the past.
Get there.
That's what this is about, Skip. The fact that Tom Brady has to worry about it because Rex Ryan not only tries to confuse him, not only tries to match wits with him and Bill Belichick. Rex Ryan makes it a point to let Brady know, you are going to feel our presence this afternoon or this evening whenever we play. It doesn't matter what happens. I'm telling you right now, I'm not going to let you sit up there in that pocket, stand around calling Giselle, ordering food for the evening, talking about where you're going and all of that other stuff. No, I'm going to put a hat on you. You're going to be completely and totally preoccupied with this contest right here because I'm coming for you. And because Tom Brady knows that, he knows that Rex Ryan will sacrifice plays and all of that stuff just to get a hat on Tom Brady. It changes things. It's tantamount to a boxer, Skip. You know, somebody that's willing to take 2, 3, 4 punches just to give you one. That's Rex Ryan against Tom Brady on many occasions, making sure come hell or high water, this man feels his presence. It's the kind of thing that led to Tom Brady losing that first Super Bowl against the Giants with Strahan and the boys, okay? And to some degree, the second Super Bowl to the Giants. It's the kind of thing that has worked against Tom Brady and the New England Patriots in the past, and Rex Ryan knows that better than anybody. I think that is what has a lot to do with it. It, of course, being the brainiac that he is on the defensive side of the ball has something to do with it. But it's primarily establishing a physical presence against Tom Brady, letting him know this is not going to be a good day for you on most occasions.
Yep.
You go up against one of my teams. That's what Rex Ryan does to Tom Brady.
And yet, Rex has done that to Brady while Rex has been a little hamstrung on his offensive side of the ball with Mark Sanchez, Geno Smith, and I'm hoping for Rex's sake that Tyrod Taylor is going to turn out to be as good as I think he's going to be, because Rex, and I'm not trying to say that Tyrod's going to be a superstar quarterback, but if he can at least be better than Mark Sanchez, Rex might go places, because with Mark Sanchez...
Wow.
He got to
two
AFC championship games with Mark Sanchez. That is an enormous achievement. And the one that he got to was he had to go through Foxborough, that game you were talking about, the 2010 game. And then they lost at Pittsburgh. And in truth, Mark Sanchez, remember there was a sack fumble that William Gay returned for a touchdown that game on Sanchez. So you probably got as far as you could with Mark Sanchez. But I can suggest to you, as much as you love Aaron Rodgers, remember, then Pittsburgh went on to that Super Bowl against Aaron Rodgers. What if somehow, some way, Rex had managed to get out of Pittsburgh still alive with Mark Sanchez and gotten to that Super Bowl? Aaron Rodgers might have had a much longer day than he had against the Pittsburgh defense. Remember, Polamalu was beat up and he wasn't right and had 4 or 5 different knick-knack injuries and couldn't really run in that game. But if Rex had gotten to that Super Bowl, I don't know, it could have been much rougher on Aaron Rodgers. I'm not sure he would have been the MVP of that game.
That's when Mark was the Sanchez.
He was the Sanchez.
That?
Well, Rex was trying to build him up.
Well, keep in mind that the real thing that was going on is that that defense was elite, okay? You had a good running game, and you had a guy like Mark Sanchez who was playing within himself because he had just entered the league his first and second years, respectively, and he was keeping the turnovers to a minimum. Then he got caught up in Sanchez, started making the circuit around New York City, being in the public eye a little bit more, started feeling himself.
Yep.
The ladies started
Pretty
coming his way.
Fresh.
Keep in mind.
Mm-hmm.
But listen. Listen, the dude was at USC prior to coming to the NFL. That's Cali. That's Southern California that he was chilling in before he came to New York City. So it's safe to say that he was a bit distracted. And that may have played a role. I'm just saying.
Maybe. So Bill Belichick responded this, and he's also low-key funny. Obviously, different sense of humor than Rex. He said, I think our record against Rex Ryan has been okay. We'll take it. He tweeted that. Excuse me, that tweet is from Mike Rodak. He heard that in a press conference there. I like it. The Ravens suffer a huge loss Sunday. Terrell Suggs is done for this year. How does no T Sizzle affect the AFC North landscape? We'll tell you that coming up.
What our fans are going to be like when you have the hated Patriots. I mean, this kind of rival coming into our stadium. I don't know if a whole lot's changed. The fact that they're kind of the hunted in my eyes, because they're the world champions. And so they were obviously won our division every single year that I've been here. So obviously they're the ones that you want to knock off.
I think Rex is liking the blue. He's always played Tom Brady and the Patriots tough as Jets head coach, obviously now staying in the division with the Bills. He inherits another solid defense and gets to face the Patriots twice a year again. Rex is fired up and ready for Bill Belichick and Brady to come to town on Sunday. But take a look at the numbers here. Brady's stats are lower in every statistical category when facing Rex Ryan. Interesting. Skip, why has Rex been able to be so successful against Brady?
Stephen A. Smith, I'm going to use a word here I don't often use on this show, and that's genius. I believe Rex Ryan is a defensive genius. I believe he's a better all-around defensive football coach than Bill Belichick. Yet Belichick's aura, his legend, his brand seems a lot bigger than Rex's as a defensive coordinating type of a strategic coach. And I don't buy it. I love Bill Belichick, as you well know. And I can make a case, certainly, that Bill Belichick is a better all-around head football coach than Rex Ryan, but not defensively. And yet, as we just saw from that soundbite, that little bit of clip that we just saw from Rex, which is only the tip of that iceberg, as you well know, Rex's showmanship continues to overshadow his strategic brilliance, because he doesn't look or act like a genius, but he is. Now, he gets a lot of help, and I think it's time for us to start to give some credit to his now defensive coordinator, Dennis Thurman, who's now calling a lot of the defenses. But with some help from Dennis, it's mostly Rex through the week compiling a game plan that always frustrates and flusters Tom Brady. Not that they're going to shut him down. They're just going to occasionally confuse him enough that Brady's a little off balance against Rex. He's not sure what's coming next, because nobody is sure what's coming next from Rex. Blitz-wise, look-wise, pass defense-wise, coverage-wise, it's always something a little bit different. And Rex is flat out arrogant about it. He's outspokenly arrogant about it. So that trickles down to his locker room. And his defenders start to get arrogant about it and think, hey, we're as good as Tom Brady is. We can do what we do as well as Tom Brady does what he does. So they're one team, and maybe the only team, now in Buffalo, obviously, used to be with the Jets, but it's the only team that's not afraid of Tom Brady, that doesn't play on its heels against Tom Brady. They attack Tom Brady because they are supremely confident they can control Tom Brady, and they often have. Again, Not that he's bad against them. He's just not Tom Brady against Rex Ryan. Advantage Rex. So he constantly drops in his little lines that we play the Patriots. You know, it's just Rex, and it's funny. Makes Molly laugh, makes me laugh. But it's showmanship, but it's showing the players again. Rex ain't afraid of no Patriot, no Belichick. He's got...